Hi everyone, Charisse here, your online therapist. Today I'm answering the question, why do I get so nervous when I fancy someone? A lot of you are dating right now or in the beginning stages of relationships, and yes, this can be a very, very nerve-wracking time. And it can be confusing. Why? Why is it nerve-wracking? If I'm feeling anxious, is that a red flag? Does it mean that it's not right? Is my instinct telling me to step away from this relationship? I think it is much more complex than that. So let's break this down. When we feel anxious, the questions we need to ask ourselves is this me? Is this part of my attachment? If we have an insecure attachment, if we are anxiously attached or avoidantly attached, anxiety is going to be part of our stories and our scripts when it comes to relationships, because relationships are complicated. Relationships have been difficult. You know, we don't always get our needs met. We always feel yearning, or we always feel suffocated, or it's not enough, or it's too much. It's kind of, relationships are fraught to some degree. So when we meet someone and we go through that initial phase and we really fancy someone, that actually can be perceived by our nervous systems as a threat. It's a threat to our safety. It's a threat to our well-being, our nice little world where we're in charge of everything and we only have to worry about ourselves. Suddenly, we are emotionally invested in someone else. Someone else liking us, someone else being attracted to us, someone else's moods, and crucially, someone else choosing us and continuing to choose us. That is very, very frightening. On a human level, that is hugely, hugely scary. So, and especially when we are perhaps feeling a little bit out of control, because we fancy someone, we've caught feelings, that then is uncomfortable for us because it's a loss of control. Suddenly now this other person can impact us, whether they like us, whether they don't, whether they text back quickly or not. All of those things have the power to impact us. And we probably all have histories where that has been difficult anyway. So the lack of control triggers our anxiety, because suddenly, you know, anxiety is about often a lack of control or a perceived lack of control. So we will feel anxious. And all of this is going to, of course, plug into our attachment trauma. So if we're anxiously attached, avoidantly attached, as I said earlier, that is going to be part of the bonding experience. I know that is so sad. It is sad. It is sad. But actually, I counsel my clients and I say the anxiety has to be tolerated at the beginning, because that can be sabotaging. You know, for those of us who are accustomed to the anxious, or maybe the more anxiously attached people, perhaps, you know, yes, you will prevail. You will get through it because you want the connection. You want the attachment ultimately. If we are a bit more avoidant, if we're a bit more fearful in our attachment style, sometimes the anxiety is too much, and that is why we walk away. We will leave a relationship before fully exploring if it's right for us, because that initial anxious bit is too much. So it's really important to recognize, okay, we're going to feel anxious. And as I say, it's to be tolerated. It's to be endured. You know, we have to emotionally regulate and self-soothe our way through it. And I also encourage you to notice your thoughts, because your scripts will be coming out. In these precarious moments when it's not fully clear if it's maybe committed yet, or the feelings are mutual, or this is going to go something of a distance, that is a difficult, difficult time, and there's going to be such a sort of vulnerability involved there. And we struggle with vulnerability. As humans, we struggle with vulnerability. If we have a history of relationship difficulty or attachment stuff, it's going to be tenfold. So this is going to be a time when your scripts are going to come out. So notice the scripts, notice the thoughts, notice the fears, notice the assumptions that you're making on the behavior, how you interpret behavior, what you make it about you or them, or how bad things are or how okay things are. You know, just begin to notice the mental gymnastics that we all do that are going to be directly related to our scripts. So you can notice, oh, this is tapping into my not good enough stuff. Oh gosh, I've been triggered into my anger now. I'm now frustrated and I'm annoyed and I'm in danger of bailing in or doing something dramatic. I need to just emotionally regulate. And if I still feel this way in a week, then maybe I will. But right now I'm noticing I'm having big, big feelings. So I think I've been triggered. What is my script saying? Is it saying that I need to protect myself? You know, damn that person, move away, or cling on for everything that you can. Just begin to notice. You know, this is the beginning of taking ourselves in hand, noticing, processing, and then acting. You know, we've got to notice our emotions. We have to figure out what they're about. We have to recognize our scripts. We have to do the self-soothing. And once we've done all of that, then we respond. Then we respond to the message or the silence or, you know, the date that, you know, we're now analyzing. You know, we have to give it time, and it's a time for us to learn about ourselves. How do we relate? Where is our hurt coming out? Where is our confidence coming out? Where is our hope coming out? Where is our apathy and bitterness and cynicism coming out? These are all moments. But it's also a moment to bring in the reparenting, to really see ourselves through the pain. Yes, you know, the agony and the ecstasy of this period is real. We are going to feel anxious. We are going to feel overwhelmed. We are going to feel vulnerable. That is the process we have to go through. That is a risk we have to take in order to bond with someone and connect and develop what is hopefully going to be a more secure attachment. It's this insecure moment in a relationship. So of course, it's going to trigger all of our stuff, and anxiety is a big one. So my advice is, do not act out on the anxiety. Really question it, understand it, look at it. A part of you is trying to express something, but it's often stuff from the past. It's old stuff coming up. It's old stuff being triggered. So understand that. Get to grips with that. Know that and separate it from this new person and this new relationship that you are exploring. And calm yourself and soothe yourself and love yourself through this so you can turn up in this relationship or beginning of a relationship in the most calm, hopeful, optimistic way that you can. Because that is how we develop the security. If we feed the anxiety, it then becomes normalized and part of how we relate in these moments. Versus we're looking after ourselves, we take ourselves in hand, we use all of our tools, and we do everything we can to contain the anxiety, to right size our fears, to keep a handle on our cynicism and our frustration, and to just give something space and time to reveal what it might be to you. I know it's hard, but it really is worth it. So really good luck. Let me know your thoughts, and I'll see you next time.